you want to remove nitrate from bodies of water, what you need more than anything is simply time. Time in which water can slow down and spread out. Time for nitrate to come in contact with living, growing things. Plants that can pull it up into their roots. Microorganisms that can breathe it away as nitrogen gases. This interaction can come in man-made and engineered forms, like saturated buffers or constructed wetlands, or in natural forms, like an intact floodplain along a river. When rivers are low, water only flows through the river channel itself and doesn't come in contact with the trees and other plants on its floodplain. But when rivers are high and swelling over their banks, which is also when they carry the most nitrate, water flows out into the surrounding landscape, where it can interact with plant roots as it slowly sinks into the ground. Studies have shown that this can lead to large reductions in the amount of nitrate within the floodwaters. For instance, one study showed that more than 75% of the nitrogen within water that overflowed the Wisconsin River's banks onto its floodplain was removed. In places where rivers are channelized, hemmed in by concrete, riprap, or levees, this connection to the floodplain is greatly reduced, and the potential to remove nitrate from the flowing water declines.